Hey guys, welcome back to an episode of Project Ozone 3 Recap Mode. Before we get into it today, I'd like to ask you all to please like, subscribe, and leave any comments you have for me down in the comments below. In addition to that, make sure to check out my Twitter, Twitch, and Discord, which are all linked in the description. You can check out my Twitch if you are just interested in seeing some live streams. We're doing some different stuff over there. Twitter, you can check out for the schedule for my live streams, of course, and also to know when these videos go live. In addition to that, you can check out the Discord, where you can just hang out and chat with people in the community playing similar games to this, similar challenging mod packs, all that kind of stuff. But yeah, other than that, let's get into it, what you actually came here to see. So, a few updates. I remember setting this up on camera, but I don't think I told you guys, so I figured out why it wasn't. If you remember when we set it up, I had to pull things out of here. And then put them into this transmutation table to like learn them. Yeah, now that I did a little bit of research. Well, not research. Someone in my Discord did a little bit of research for me and realized it's because I didn't set the priority high enough. So now I've set this priority to pretty much as high as I could possibly before it wouldn't let me click the button anymore. And it should be as you craft things. So if I autocraft something, let's say this is a good example. If we have the stuff for it, hopefully we have the stuff for it. We do. Okay. So watch. As soon as this crafts, we'll have a million of these because it's got EMC. It'll take a second because I think the thing I chose has to actually go into here. Yep. Give it a second. There we go. As soon as this finishes crafting and gets back into the network, we'll have 1 point. Yep. 1 mil. And the same goes for these things. Just as an example, if we have the stuff for it, we may not actually have the stuff for these ones. No, we do. Okay. It should take 2 seconds. And yeah, but it illustrates my point. So, with that, our big project this week is going to be to try and get this ultimate singularity. And to do that, we are going to set up a bit of a machine. I think we're going to do it over here. I want to kind of set it up before we decide, well, just how exactly we're going to do this. So I think the plan is to have, we probably want, I want 4 per row. I think this works out pretty well. Get some torches. So the plan is to have a bit of a redstone set up to tell it when it's done, because you can't set up an autocrafting pattern really for this machine. So yeah, so I have all of the ultimate catalysts to do this, and we're going to essentially set up a big array of these, but for the sake of everyone's sanity and not watching me set all of these up, I'm just going to set up one to show you how it's going to work, and then I'll set up one bank of them. So essentially, we're going to have these are all export buses. They're going to export the blocks we need into the quantum compressor. Then we are going to use, where is that? Conduits. That's not what we need. Oops. Stone. What are they called? They're the at apply. There's a redstone, something like a redstone card. That's what we need. Okay. Should now have a million of those. And we'll pull some speed cards too, just to have them on us. Essentially, what we want to set up is at is a system where we'll pull. That many of those, and we need to put some down here, and we'll have one. So we put redstone card in this, and then set it to active without signal. Levels are above or equal to, we want the limit to be set, let me think, so we need one singularity per each of these infinite catalysts, and we need 1, 2, 3, 4, 8, 9, 10, we need 10 per each of these, we need 9 of these ingots to do what we want, so we need 90 singularities essentially, so I'm going to set it to emit when above 90, and then we'll put a singularity in here as soon as we have it set up. And then essentially that will emit, it'll shut off our export bus, and then it'll quit putting them into the compressor. And then all we need is some import bus, where the import bus is. We don't want storage buses, import. Could have sworn I had import. Oh, they're there. And then this will be pulling out. And then there'll be one of these in here. Yeah. And essentially, we're just going to. We're just going to set that up for every single one of these. And we'll do it on some dense cables so that. I think this whole thing, these dense cables have 32 channels, I think. Let me check that. 32 channels, right? This is, nope. That's not what I wanted. There we go. This is 32 channels. Okay, so 32 channels. And what we essentially want to do is, so each of these takes up, I think, 3 channels per each block. So that's 6, 12, 24. This would be 36. So I think like up to here is one P2P. And then this section will be, there's going to be a bunch of P2Ps. But I will essentially just go through and do all the kind of crappy stuff that has to be done, and then we will come back once I, because some of these aren't EMCable, the ones that aren't EMCable we will have to take care of, so I'll come back once I have this, the EMCable singularities set up, and then we can get back to work on some of the other stuff. So yeah, I will be right back once this crazy ass thing is set up. All right guys, we're back. So I've been doing a little bit of work. By a little bit, I mean quite a bit. This is our insane setup now for making singularities. We have pretty much all of them set up, aside from the non-EMCable ones, which we're going to have to spawn in blocks for. Those we have, we'll take up what's left of these condensers. But, it does give us this very beautiful image, and if I leave this for probably about an hour, hour and a half, I should end up with, other than this one which I messed up when I was setting it up, about 90 of every single one of these singularities. Aside from these ones, which are all the ones we still need to make, the jade, flux electrum, crystalline pink slime, manganese, thaxium dash, meteoric iron, night metal, steel leaf, fiery ironwood, and a wicked draconium. Those being ones that I need to spawn in. So, yeah, that's going to require me to set up more things for spawning them in. Sorry about any loud noises in the background. So that is what we need to do for that. This. Infinity. Okay. So, some things we need to work on is getting all these set up to spawn in. We need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 different singularities. So, for 12 different singularities, which means we need 12 sets of blocks, we are going to need more I always do that to myself. Now off of that, I need another bunch of these mob duplicators. Let's see how many we have already. We have one left, plus I think, is there one over here? So there's one there. I can really kind of, I don't need this setup over here. This was just a very primitive starter setup for. Okay, so we have, I'm gonna need to go to the void. Oh, I hate that noise every time I come in here. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. We need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We need 8 more. So I need to craft up some of those. Now let's just go back to base this way. And I'm pretty sure, if I understand correctly, the spawning mechanics of those mob spawners, I should be able to just put them all in that spawning room. I believe I can get up to 64 in that spawning room before it starts to have problems. So yeah, that'll be nice. So give me a couple minutes to get all these mob duplicators. And actually, we need one less than I said. So we need 7. Because this Ataxium is actually EMCable. And we'll have to do some Abyssalcraft stuff for it. So we will get into that Abyssalcraft stuff in a minute. But let's first get all these mob duplicators going. Because I know that spawning in these singularities, or spawning in these blocks to do the singularities, is a much slower process. And I want to get it going so that we don't have to wait around forever for it. So yeah, I will be right back. And yeah, we'll go from there. So see you guys in a minute. Yerby. Alright guys, we're back. So, I did one quick thing while we were going, and that was to get this final sword. I claimed the quest for having a bunch of singularities. It's inside. I haven't claimed them all, but I won't claim them all really until we get the ultimate singularity, because then I'll have to pick them all up to put them in here. Plus, some of these we don't even have. Some of these I don't even think we need for the ultimate singularity that are in here. There's a couple in here that I don't think we ever made. Yeah, so sorry for that continuously going off. It might go off a little bit longer. But, oh my god. Sorry guys about the music. This will do 301 hearts of damage. And it's got an absurd amount of looting, plus it adds a bunch of hearts to our health. So, ignoring that while it continues to spam go off, there's one last thing we're going to need, or kind of two last things we need to do to get these singularities set up. So, we have most of the blocks made, or already spawned in. We're missing two blocks, which is the fiery ingot one and the manganese. Manganese is kind of a weird one. Oh, I forgot that we could do that. So we just need some... this... granite. My god. That's just gonna keep going off on us. Sorry. Oh, I think we're finally done. Okay, so we just need to smelt this to get... oh, we have a bunch of manganese dioxide ingots. Just let those turn into manganese, and then I think it's just a crafting recipe ingot. Nope. Some of these ingots are crafting recipes. Some of them you have to actually go about blockifying. So manganese. So essentially the only spawnable one we don't have is this fiery one. And the reason why we don't have this fiery one. How hard are these? Okay, this requires, yeah, even more blocks. And now we're just better off animating it. So what I was going to say is the reason why we don't have this fiery one is because of this. So each ingot requires this for its crafting recipe. These seem the same. I don't know why it's two separate ones, but. Which we, what was that? Oh, it's just you can recycle them. Okay. Yeah, so we don't have the stuff to do this. Can this be used? Seven. One more than we need, actually. So a single ingot can just go in here. Blockify that. And now comes the fun part. Mob imprisonment. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Six, seven, eight. Okay, now we essentially just get to go through. That has such a weird texture. Let me go over here. Alright, and this is going to take a little while, so... so, I'm going to leave you guys for now, and I'll come back once I have these all animated. So, see you guys in a minute. Bye. Or BRB. Alright guys, we're back. So I did a little bit of work off camera because all we have left to get is this Ephaxium stuff. Which is EMC-able, but first we need to get our hold on it. So we need to get a life crystal. This is the easiest way to do it at least. So now we have essentially infinite life crystals. Now all we need to do is get the... let's do this. And we have it. And then this prevents us having to go and do a bunch more abyssal craft to get it. Which is nice. And then all we have left to do is... it required a lot of crystallization and stuff. Show the last one of these we will have to set up. And then... a stack of those. Stone. cable. Little conduit probe. I already have set up. Should be pretty quick. So there is one more of these than I think we needed. I'm hoping that is the case, that it is, there is one more than we needed, and I didn't mess up and miss one. We'll definitely find out when we go to set up the ultimate singularity for next episode, and it's not there. If it's not there, then we'll know I missed something, and I'll go back and figure out what it was that I missed. Alright, and then, oop. And this singularity should start forming relatively quickly. I can also put that away. For the moment, I'll keep that. And also, I wanted to show you guys... Oh, oops. Sorry. To finish off the episode, that we do have all these mobs very beautifully dying in the mob system. Pretty efficient. I mean, it's not going to make singularities at hyperspeed. I probably could have done 2 blocks of each, or even more than that, to ramp up the production a lot more. But this will work. I'm just going to have to leave it for a little while. And yeah, that's about it for me. I hope you enjoyed the episode. We'll be back next time, probably making the ultimate singularities and either moving on into the next part of doing, of working towards infinity ingots. Or we might take a quick detour and do the armor quest to get up to the powered armors, the armors that run on power, so that we could kind of ditch the armor we have now and get some better creative flight we can use in other dimensions. So that if we go to a dimension that doesn't have the ability to use creative flight in it, we can take care of that. But yeah, other than that, have a good day, guys. You're free to leave. You're still there? Go on, get out of here. Shoo. You're free. That's all we're doing for like the next 5 years until this makes singularity. All right, goodbye, guys.